What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. My name's Alexa, and I'm so happy to have you here with me today. On today's video, I wanted to talk about manifestation and manifestation stories. So I find that everyone's trying to manifest, right? You can literally watch all of the videos, read all of the things, but sometimes it's just so much easier to understand how to manifest when someone is just simply telling you how they're manifesting in their day-to-day lives. So if you're curious on how to manifest, or you really want to know how manifestation works in the real world, then this video is for you. Don't mind the fact that my face does not match my body right now. I got my sleeve worked on, so I cannot use my sunless tanner, and I'm still in New York right now, and it's winter. So I am quite pale, and I inadvertently bought the wrong foundation color. I don't love quarantine because you can't try anything on, so here we are. I wanted to talk to you today about manifestation and manifestation stories. I'm going to start sharing more stories of how I manifest things. I'm hoping that by me sharing the stories of me taking my manifestation tips and tricks and habits and really sharing with you how I'm practically applying them, I hope that this will give you some insight that perhaps the skeptic in you is still questioning. Is manifestation still really a thing? Is the law of attraction real? Are all of these people crazy? I mean, here's the thing. There's so many people talking about manifestation, and all of the people talking about it are manifesting the lives of their dreams. They're manifesting the things that they want. So even if your rational mind wants to fight against this, there's so much evidence to support this is true. And manifestation really comes down to quantum physics, quantum mechanics. This video is not going to be on quantum mechanics, but there is science behind manifestation. So if you're coming at this from a rational mind because it's too esoteric for you, then let's take the esoteric hat off and let's put our scientist hat on, because both apply here. And that's why I'm always taking esoteric beliefs and merging them with practical, tangible habits, because I really believe that the esoteric, the knowledge and the wisdom there, that's what we're missing in life. And then if we can apply it to the modern day society that we're living in, that's when the magic happens, right? So let's become manifestation queens. Let's become manifestation kings. You have the manifestation capacity within you. You just gotta shut out that rational mind that's trying to tell you it can't happen, because that's always gonna block it out. Let's talk about today. And this is not going to be some major manifestation. I didn't manifest a car today, you know, but this is a beautiful story to help you understand how manifestation truly works. And most people don't believe that they can manifest a car in a day, so they're not going to. Your belief is half of the manifestation process. This is a beautiful one because this is simply manifesting a free coffee. Anybody can manifest a free coffee, right? And this is a beautiful place to start with manifestation. Start small because your beliefs are already behind the small things. So the one thing that I want to share that is just really downloading through to me every single day recently and multiple times throughout the day, so I feel called to share it with the collective, is that you are in the present moment. You are fully aligned. You are living your full purpose. All of your chakras are aligned because you're living in the now. You're not worried about what's going to happen in the future. You're not getting depressed about what happened in the past. And the future is always going to, we're always trying to do. We're never trying to be. And that's where the beauty really comes in, is our beingness. How can we enjoy the present moment? How can we understand that we have goals, we have things that we want to achieve, but regardless, if we are at the very beginning of our journey and we have so many things on our list and we feel like we really haven't achieved much, If we're not enjoying the present moment, if we're not appreciating what we do have, the universe is never gonna give us more. And you're probably not gonna feel worthy of having more because you're not allowing yourself to step into your self-worth and really honoring your truth. The moment allows you to just find joy, find happiness in whatever you're seeing, whatever you're experiencing, right? Because generating happiness comes within us. We generate happiness, we generate wealth, we generate everything we need within us. And whenever we are looking outside of ourselves to feel fulfillment within, we are setting ourselves up for failure. You are only ever going to be fulfilled within if you are going within for the fulfillment. Yes, other things in the external world can provide momentary fulfillment, but ultimately, everything that's showing up in your external world is a manifestation of what you're feeling on the inside. So if you're feeling amazing, you're going to just keep having amazing manifestations appear. And that's when people just seemingly have it all. They have the best relationship. They drive an amazing car. They have an awesome house. They have great businesses. And they don't just even have one business. They've got multiple businesses. They're going on trips. They're doing all of these things that it seems like, how do they have all of these things? It's because they're not looking at anyone else who has all of these things going, how do they have this? They are focusing on themselves. They are focusing on making their lives the most divine life that they can have, which means going after what you want. It means deciding that you're worthy of having all of the things, of having an amazing relationship, of having a house, of having the car, having all of these things. The people that decide they're worthy of these things are the ones that get them. And because when you feel worthy, you feel confident, you feel amazing, you start living that way. And it's like, why would you ever go back to the ego mind running the show? When you start living in a heart-centered space and you start controlling your energy, your vibration, and raising it higher and higher and higher, and you start asking the universe for more and more and more, you can transform your life. The thing is, you don't even necessarily need to know all of that. If you're working on finding joy in the present moment, finding happiness, if you're working on aligning your frequency with the happiness, abundance frequency, with the frequency of love, compassion, everything else is going to flow to you. Today, I woke up, I did my morning routine, I got myself into a great, great mood. And I say this because I need 8 to 9 hours of sleep a night. For me, that is what I need. I do not perform my best, I do not show up as the best version of myself without that. Consciously aware of this, I go to sleep, I get these hours of sleep. Last night though, I felt really called to download this book and read this book after I got out of this really amazing chat on Clubhouse that I am so grateful I was there for. And I ended up being up until 1 in the morning. Y'all, I normally go to sleep at 10. The morning is late for me, except when a Lakers game is on. Sometimes on at 10. But if there's not a Lakers game on, your girl is in bed at 10. Up till 1 p.m. last night, reading this amazing book. I'm so glad I did it. But waking up this morning, I didn't have as much energy as I would normally. My body ached a little bit. I really just like, I wasn't in the best mood. So you know what I did? I got myself an amazing mood. I said how amazing today was gonna be. I said how grateful I was. I got myself in a high energetic state. I went outside, I let ghosts out. I breathed some fresh air. I let the sun shine on my face. I came in, I did a meditation. I did some breath work. I got myself where I needed to be. I aligned with the abundance frequency. I got myself in a good state. I got myself into alignment. I was ready to take on the day. I made sure before I started my day, before I interacted with anyone, anything, I had gotten myself right. Before I had to go to my appointment this afternoon, I was feeling amazing. Then I drove to my appointment. I listened to some high vibe music. I was loving it. I even stayed in my car for an extra minute to finish the song because I was literally dancing and singing and I was in such a good mood. Go to my appointment, get out. I had to go stop at Target to go get some things. Let's drop some wisdom on wealth consciousness while we're here. So while I'm at Target, I get myself into an abundant mood. I tell myself how much of a wealthy woman I am. I walk around feeling like a wealthy woman. Allow myself to get what I need without letting the price dictate it. There were these triangle bras that I really wanted to try and I decided it was gonna be $10. And then I look at the price tag because I wanted to get two of them. And the last time I got one of these, they didn't fit well. So I wanted it to be a cheap price and it was $10. So I was able to get two of them. I walked around Target feeling abundant. I didn't allow myself to get a pit in my stomach. Walked around feeling like a wealthy woman because wealth is a frequency that you align to. It's a consciousness level. Money doesn't determine your wealthiness. Your wealthiness determines how much money you have. So you gotta get yourself in a wealthy vibration. I went around, I got the things that I needed. I didn't let price dictate anything I was buying because I know I deserve the best. I needed a new phone case. I got one of the most expensive phone cases. Why? Because I have a really nice phone and my phone deserves to be protected. I do a lot of business on my phone. I speak to a lot of my clients using my phone. So yes, I deserve to have a good phone. And yes, I also deserve to have a really good phone case. My other phone case, I'm just clumsy. And I had dropped it so many times that it was an amazing phone case, but it just wasn't looking as good. So I got a new phone case. I didn't let it trip me out. Was it expensive? No, it was an investment. And I went through, I purchased and invested my money wisely. I knew that everything I was buying was purposeful. I didn't go in spending money unnecessarily or go to a sales rack and buy something because I felt like that's all I was worth. I am worthy than more than just the sale rack. If you like to shop sales racks and it makes you feel wealthy to get a good sale, then do it, girl, do it. If you're shopping the sales rack because you feel that that's all you're good enough for, that's when that's a problem. You have to feel abundant when you're buying things. You have to know your worth because money is just energy. And as long as you're spending intentionally on things that you want and need and things that are going to serve a purpose, the money is just gonna flow right back to you. You don't ever have to be worried. Spend abundantly, but spend purposefully. I'm cashing out, and as I'm sliding my card, I go, this money is going to come back to me tenfold. That's the thought I have while I'm swiping my card, and I get my energy behind that, and I deadass meant it when I said that. The amount of money I just spent at Target wasn't even a thing, because I'm gonna get that tenfold, just because I spent it on what I needed and what I knew I was worth. It's going to come back to me. I am leaving Target, and I was like, ooh, I'd really like a chai tea latte right now. Now, I don't always drink Starbucks because you'll see, if you follow me on my stories on Instagram, I'm always calling out brands for adding way too much sugar. Today, I was like, you know, I really want a chai tea latte. And then my ego goes, but do you really need a chai tea latte? You just spent this and you just spent this and shouldn't you just go home and get to work? What felt abundant to me? Was it the thought that said, I really want a chai tea latte right now? Or was it the one that said, you should go home and work? I'm gonna go get a chai tea latte. It's across the street. So I pull out and the line for Starbucks is so long. So my ego again goes, see, look at that line. It's a sign you should just go right home. And I was like, who let you in this car, sir? I'm gonna need you to take a back seat. I'm the one driving. And I said, you know what? That is a long line. But if that Jeep right there that's at the drive-thru window, if that pulls out before this light turns green, I'm gonna take that as a sign that I deserve this chai tea latte. Literally, as I thought that, I wasn't even finished saying the last word in my head, the Jeep pulls out. So what do? I go and I pull up to Starbucks. There was probably easily 10 cars in front of me. I didn't care, I had an amazing playlist, I was dancing, I was parked, so I was responding to my messages, I was working on my business, so I was working, right? Like the ego told me to go home and work. I was still working. Was I home? No, but I was still working. I go, you know, I really wish Starbucks had oat milk. What I'm gonna ask. So I order my drink and then I was like, what kind of plant-based milks do you have? They've only had almond milk forever. Granted, I haven't gone to a Starbucks in a minute. And he's like, yeah, we've got almond milk and oat milk. And I was like, sweet. So then I get oat milk. And that's exactly what I wanted. I wanted a venti chai tea latte with oat milk. So I get this. Enjoyed my experience while waiting. I was in a great mood the whole time. Then I pull up to the drive-thru to pay. He goes, you know, I have an extra frappe here. Did you want it? And I was like, yeah, like that would be amazing. Oh my God, thank you so much. So then he got really excited and he was like, yeah. And I was like, this is so cool. And he was like, yeah, it is, right? Had such a big smile on my face. I had a smile on my face the whole way driving home. I was so happy. And you know what I just realized? So let's backtrack. I wanna tell you how powerful your mindset and what you're saying to yourself is. While I was driving to my eyelash appointment this morning, I told myself over and over and over again, I love you so much, Alexa. I love you so much, Alexa. I love you so much, Alexa. And I had a smile on my face while I said it. I really meant it. I said that for at least a minute to myself while I was driving, while I was dancing, while I was just out doing my thing. I intentionally raised my vibration. I intentionally said things in my mind today and out loud that were going to raise the frequency of my life experience. I decided today was going to be an amazing day and I made it an amazing day. You get to decide. Life will support you. When you decide, life gets to be good. Life is oh so good. You know that storytelling is so powerful, and that's one thing that I do all of the time. Like, if you know me in my personal life or you get into discussions and conversations with me, I've always got a story. And for better or for worse, right? It's like Big Fish, that movie Big Fish, how the dad's always telling stories and the son is just annoyed by it, but everyone else is enamored by his stories. I totally get that there's some people that don't resonate with my stories and I drive them crazy, and that's totally fine. You don't have to listen to my stories. But also know that so many other people really do get lit up by the stories I share and by my energy. And I tell people all the time, my clients when I'm working with them or people in my day-to-day life, that you can literally be in someone's space and you can pick up a higher vibration, a higher frequency. That's like when you're around someone and they're super positive, they're super happy, they're really determined, they have an amazing life, they're confident, or they're just so high vibe that it's like electricity being around them and you just wanna be around them more. That's normal. We all will go down sometimes in vibration, but it's about how quickly can you notice that you went down and how can you honor what made you go down, feel it, and then how can you choose to reframe it, change your perspective, and start raising your vibration again. If you feel like you're low vibrational one day, put on a video of somebody that makes you high vibe. If it's not me, that's fine. Go find somebody though. That's why you should have a high vibe tribe. If you don't have people in your life, that's what's so beautiful about YouTube and things of this nature. Listen to a podcast, go to someone's YouTube channel, get on Clubhouse, find someone high vibe and allow their high vibes to fill you up. Don't get reliant on that person for their high vibe. When you're feeling a little low, just shift yourself because it's all about your mindset. Your mindset's gonna determine how you're feeling in a moment. So decide to feel better, okay? comment below something that you have recently manifested and share a quick little story. I truly believe that we're all gonna grow and we're all gonna be able to be more conscious manifestors when we start sharing stories like these. Instead of just giving all of the tips and tricks on how to manifest, let's share the actual stories that show that this manifestation thing is a real thing, because it's changing our life experience. It's making it so we get to live better lives, and that's what I'm here to help you do. I want to shift the consciousness level upwards. I want everyone to have abundance in all areas of their lives. You deserve to live the most incredible life. You absolutely deserve it. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today. I am so, so grateful for you. If you're not already following me on social media, I'm on Instagram and Clubhouse every single day. I would love to chat with you on Clubhouse. And I'm always posting on Instagram throughout the day. So if you're curious about behind the scenes of my life, then I would absolutely love to see you there. Love you so much. Thank you for being here today, and we'll chat soon.